Hello, Channel Need viewers. This is another episode on Channel Need. I am reporter DS.
And I'm Chorus Yuki.
Hey, so the previous episode, we actually talked about social identity, so we introduced this concept. So in this episode, we are going to specifically talk about social identity of being a Singaporean. So Yuki and I are Singaporeans and totally Singaporean, right?
Totally.
Yeah, so in the previous chapter, we talked about the concept of social identity being fluid. So it means that it can change over time. So sometimes you may feel more Singaporean than others.
Yeah.
So we talk about how, in what occasions do we sometimes feel more Singaporean than others, than other times.
Okay, I guess personally for me, I would think overseas. Like when I'm in Singapore, sometimes I'll complain about Singapore, like, wow, very hot, or say, wow, Singapore is a fine city, you get it? But then when I'm overseas, I would think about Singapore being so much better than, no offense, but it's like, oh, there's so much luxury, so much priorities for me as a Singaporean, healthcare is so much better, education is so much better, so on and so forth.
Yes.
Like, I would think about how lucky I am as a Singaporean, I'll feel very proud. And when I see another fellow Singaporean, when I hear the Singlish, like, okay lah, then I'll, oh, Singaporean! Yeah, that's what I would do. Like, I suddenly feel very at home when I see a fellow Singaporean overseas.
So this means that when you are overseas, you are more likely to feel Singaporean.
Yeah.
Isn't it so?
Very weird, yeah.
Okay, so I was also thinking that in another situation, I also tend to feel more Singaporean than I used to. That's during the time when there are Olympics or SEA Games or Asian Games. So Singapore, when they are participating, I will always seem to be more patriotic. Like, I'm always rooting behind a Singaporean athlete. So like, regardless of whether it's swimming, or whether it's badminton or table tennis, I would want Singapore to win.
Yeah.
But when they lose, right, I still feel very Singaporean.
Yeah, true. I will feel like,
so regardless of whether they win or lost, it just makes me feel like, okay, I'm very proud of Singapore.
Yeah.
So this is one of the other moments. So can you come up with another moment whereby we can actually feel very Singaporean?
Okay, just to be very relevant right now, will be probably the COVID-19 case, the crisis that we are facing as a whole entire collective unit of Singapore. So I feel very proud to say this because around my area where I stay, I have a neighbor who actually plays like bottles of sanitizers,
yes,
and they hang it in every single block. Like, we have two different streets, so the street 1 and street 2. And this neighbor actually, according to my friend who stays in street 2, also has bottles hang in their lift as well.
My lift also, like.
Oh, really? Yeah, but we stay very different. Yeah, so, but I guess, yeah, good for them. Like, they're really embracing the Singaporean spirit, the psychological defense and total defense. They have it there. And I guess that's where the Singaporean spirit comes out, where you actually want each and every one of your fellow citizen and countrymen to stay safe. Yeah.
Correct. So actually in my lift, so some neighbor actually put up a notice saying that in this period of COVID-19, please be safe and please be hygienic. You know? So they put this bottle of sanitizer there as well. And then what actually happened was the next day, right, the entire piece of paper, you see a lot of xie, thank you, terimakasih, you know. Is this the same in your lift?
No, it was just a small bottle, so cannot write. You want to vandalize the bottle, you know? It's so nice to actually, you don't want to vandalize the bottle.
Oh, no, because my neighbor actually put a piece of paper alongside with the sanitizer. It's a big bottle of sanitizer.
Yeah.
And it's very heartwarming to see that there are a lot of people thanking the neighbor for this neighbor is anonymous, but
yeah.
I think the gesture is very sweet, right?
Yeah, it is. Because, like, the neighbor actually gave the sanitizer bottle with a heart-shaped post-it note stick on top of it. And then we just didn't want to, you know, touch it or anything because it's so nice, really, so we don't want to vandalize it. But there was a period of time where it disappeared. We were like, oh, okay, no more already. But then apparently he or she took it back to replenish and hang again. So, good for you.
So as you know, our social identity can actually change over time. It can increase or it can decrease. So this will be very important for the government because I think the government will always want us to feel very Singaporean.
True.
Instead of us identifying with a particular religion or a particular ethnic group, right? So a question for you is, do you think you will actually feel more Singaporean when you sing the national anthem?
I guess maybe yes, or I'm not quite sure to say this because I've not sang the national anthem in a very long time.
Neither have I.
But when I go to school to work or do my programs, I look at the students doing their, I mean, I see the students doing their taking their pledge and singing the national anthems, I would still stand up and, you know, mumble the song along. Like, mumble the anthem again.
Mumble?
I would still mumble, like...
Lip sync, is it?
Lip sync! I would lip sync the national anthem.
Lip sync not sincere, leh.
Yeah, but then the sincerity comes in my goosebumps.
Okay.
Like, oh, yeah, I haven't sang this in a while, I feel very patriotic when I hear it. Oh. I feel proud, you know?
Oh, okay. So, one of the questions I may ask you again is, if the government, the Singapore government, wants to make you feel more like a Singaporean, what could they do for a person in your age group?
Okay, so basically what I think is, because the world is so connected, so we have globalization going on now. So the fact is that we are all so connected and we are all so influenced by other people's religion, cultures, and so on and so forth, such as K-pop. Like, oh, everyone wants to be Korean, be oppa, you know, like have an oppa in their life, or they like to drink soju,
oh,
eat Korean. No. No. And then at the end of the day, we kind of lose a little bit of our social identity as Singaporean,
yes,
because we do not know what's so uniquely us, uniquely Singaporean. And I feel that the government needs to help. The government needs to help us to actually find back our Singaporean identity.
Is there a Singaporean identity?
Like how we are so racially...
Hey, we can do an episode on that, right?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, yeah, we... up.
So anyway, I'm planning for an episode to come whereby I will invite one of my foreign students, he's a Korean, to talk about what he sees or perceives or how he views the Singaporean, so that might be interesting. And if you do like our videos and you think it's original and interesting, do subscribe to us so that we can actually grow as a community. And what we're going to do is, for today, for now, we're going to say thank you very much for joining us on this episode, and we will see you again very soon. Goodbye.